7 or 7 o'clock, I hit the blocks like a jig. A flossy chop top for wag on them D's. Bouncing as I pour late up the block, my way. Champagne, white, and gold, bro, at ease as I make way. Yeah.
I skate like a true OG for real. Second switch, tail drop, third switch, three wheels.
Spinning blocks as I mob to the beaches zone. Glass house, pancake, and blue and black two tone. Giving it up, but my foe ain't no joke. Low 16 switches, breaking them off like it's death row.
Ooh. Young pride is a loaf from the squad, big baby. The D.O. like creep blowing, those can't fade.
On a mission, dropping the hits that bust. Hitting the corners like G's, bro, I know the kids out, you're really at ease.
Alright.
Havoc regulating on y'all's, the 5 dubs are like west side to east side, I got the G slide. With the beans on high, I'm off the down low. S.C. till I die, keep the folk drop down low. Twist it, so Y.S.C. to the C.G. 1, 2, 3, L.B. Break them off like a O.G.
Don't you know we'll take your mind. Something happens here all the time. Close your eyes and don't you know that you can come with me through the funkiness and the rhythm of the SEC.
Be coming around your block in the rack, 6 foot, hitting switches like a light, on and off, green, let's roll. Everybody chilling with the G-Funk vibe, take a toke of this and dumb G-slide. Kick it with your homies, have a drink and be real, that's the way we doing it for the 9-4 pal. Homie, what you wanna call it when you hit me up, a SC thing, what I swang when I give it up.
I was hyper days ago, that was days ago, it didn't faze me though in 94, everything moves slow.
You to the S to the C,
a G, it's only me. P-R-O-D, you see?
Voila.
As I bounce like breast to chest,
what's next?
The G in me, I don't stress. Nevertheless, as I swoop in my 86 coupe,
Lexus.
94, boy, cartels reckless. And not giving up a great, but wait, your girl wanna take me on a date. I skate on a dub 5B, triple gold, give me love, big baby.
It's an SC thing, and I'm sweet.
All right, I'm Model K Payne. I'm with Getty Down Radio, and I'm here with Prode'je with South Central Cartel. How are you today?
What's up? Chilling.
So, where are you from?
South Central, Los Angeles.
All right, where are you residing at?
South Central.
Okay. Most definitely. Tell me something about yourself. Tell the viewers about yourself.
Well, I mean, for those that don't know, my name is Prode'je. I'm from a rap group called South Central Cartel. And we've been around forever. You know, we've been around since our first album came out in like 91. So, you know, we've been doing this music thing steady since 91. You know, we took a little bit of a break, though, like around at the end of the 90s. then, you know, we jumped back in it. Probably like, well, we never quit, but we kind of was just low key doing our thing, just in the streets and whatnot. And, you know, just, man, you know, reintroduce this gangsta shit to the world. You know what I mean? The way we do it, of course. But, you know, I'm a guy that started the South Central Cartel. I'm the one that handpicked every member. And I'm the producer and a rapper in the group. So, for those that don't know, I was producing all that stuff that we were putting out back then, all the way up to now. And, you know, every member of the SCC was a friend of mine. Well, that's how we ended up, that's how those guys ended up in the group. Like, as I was coming up and I was, you know, doing my thing, at some point in time, I was affiliated with each member. You know what I mean? I met one of the DJs was a pop locker. I used to watch him pop lock when I was a kid. You know, and as I grew up and I started doing music, he had a little drum machine at his house. So I would go to his
house. So what DJ was that?
DJ Chaos.
Okay.
We had two DJs. Yeah, we had two DJs. One DJ Chaos, and then we had DJ Grip.
Okay.
DJ Chaos was a locker. He was a part of a locking crew called the Majestics. So as a kid, I used to just stand out and watch them cats pop, you know, do what they did. But as I got older and I started rapping, this guy had a little bit of equipment in his room. So I would go to his house and he would make these corny ass beats. And I would rap to him, but you know, back then I didn't give a damn. I just, even though back then that's pretty much what it was. They would be, wait a minute, okay. I'm happy, that's happening.
We have a, hey,
all right
now.
I see his face, but I see his, I see Havoc here. Is he on there?
Not yet, he hasn't popped up yet.
Took his ass forever to do that. But, yeah, so, you know, so I met Chaos, you know, from that. And then the other DJ, I met him when I used to be in the streets doing my thing, just in the streets being a hard head.
Okay.
One of the streets that I used to go and mess around on, he lived on the street. He used to always try to run me off the block because it was his block. But I was like, you know, over there doing what I was doing. You know what I mean? He didn't want me over there. So, I mean, you know, that's how I knew him. I met LV kind of the same way. LV used to be in the hood blowing. Another neighborhood, LV would be walking around blowing. One day I seen LV walking down the street. Dude was singing, Stevie Wonder's Part-Time Lover. Yeah, Stevie Wonder, Part-Time Lover. This fool was blowing. And you know, I didn't know he can sing like that. And I was like, dude, I'm gonna mess with you, homie. I'm a rapper. I told him I rap because he didn't nobody know I could rap. Because I was in the streets. I wasn't walking around rapping. I was doing other shit. I wasn't rapping. But I told LV, I said, dude, I rap, homie. I'm gonna come back and get you, bro. So you know, it's like Havoc the Rhyme. So not this Havoc. But there's another Havoc in the group, Havoc the Rhyme, so he's the rapper. So in the SEC, you got two Havocs. This guy here, that can't get his damn phone to work. And then you got Havoc the Rhyme Son, which is Havoc the Rhyme Son is my cousin. That's okay. My first cousin. So we just grew up rapping together. Just, you know what I mean? Me and him would just be walking around the neighborhood busting rhymes. So when me and this guy, I met this guy, by the way, I was at my sister's house.
Okay.
And this dude, he was trying to talk to my sister.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, this particular day, I used to walk around back in the days with a like a briefcase full of racks and shit. I used to carry this shit around with me. And he seen me one day sitting out on the porch by my sister's writing. He came out the house and was like, oh, being nosy, like, what you doing, dude? Like, man, I rap. So, you know what I mean? He got, oh, man, my father wanted to shine lights and blah, 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 blah. I'm like, oh, is that right? Your boss wanted to shine lights. So, you know, I'm like, okay, I thought the fool knew something. I'm like, his pops wanted to shine lights. He can probably make something happen. that's how I met this guy. So, you know, from that day forward, of course, we was homies. We started riding with this music stuff. So me and him was doing our thing. It was Havoc and Prode'je. Early on, before we even started, like, we had,
let's see if we could get Havoc in the conversation. Hold on just a second. Hold on, don't. So, you met him and you kept going.
I met this guy. Before I met Havoc, I was already, like, grinding. Like, just young guy, just trying to get on, you know what I mean? DJ Chaos, you know, because he was a proper, he knew certain people. And one of his homeboys was singing on Ice-T's records. He was singing on, he was messing with Ice-T then. So I used to go around Ice-T and rap as a young dude, trying to get on, you know. I couldn't get Ice-T to sign me, man. He wouldn't fuck with me. I think it's because I was better than all the niggas over there. Anyway, so when I met this guy, me and him started, you know, doing our thing. And you know, Havoc, I don't gotta tell you, the boy can talk. Dude talks, you know what I mean? So me and him started doing our thing, you know what I mean? And we met certain people that helped us develop our sound and get a nice sound, and the music started actually sounding good. You know, like, we could do something with this. It went from what the DJ Chaos had, which was just a drum machine, to like full-blown production, music, everything. We met a good producer. And me and this guy was going hard trying to get a deal. It was, you know, we was knocking on the door, and we started feeling like, you know what, man, we're gonna get a deal. Like, it's coming. We can feel it coming, right? So one day I was like, hey, you know what? I got a lot of homies that want to be in this business, too. I think we should start a group. That's, you know what I mean? We started another group for a hot minute. We was called Mayhem. What was the name of that group? Mafia Style? Yeah, Mafia Style. And then, you know, he was Mafia Style for a minute. You know, nothing happened. Eventually, everybody went their own way. Then me and Happy kept on making music. And then we decided to start a group with everybody. And that's when we started the South Central Cartel. You know, we went and got everybody I knew that wanted to do this. I'm like, man, we'd do better if we just all come together and just start a big group. And we pushed, so from that point on, it was South Central Cartel. That's the short story how the SCC started. Okay. You know what I mean? And somewhere up in that time frame, I started producing the music, because when we would go to this guy that I said we met that had the professional sound, dude was good. He can play the music and all that.
Who was that with the professional sound?
That guy had the professional sound. He did. The only problem was, it wasn't grimy enough. It wasn't hip-hop enough. That's the word.
And who was that?
His name was Chris Johnson. He called himself Jammarama. Chris Jammarama Johnson.
Okay.
He was a white boy that had some, he had some soul. So we met this guy, and he was dope. It's just he didn't give us that extra little hip-hop edge that we needed, so. What I started doing, I'm like, Chris, this shit is dope, dude, but we need something else. So I started going home, listening to old school records and finding little samples and stuff. And then I would come back to Chris and say, all right, Chris, this is what I want to do right here, bro. Take this, sample this. And I started helping him do it. I started co-producing. I wasn't technically touching nothing, but I was basically telling him what to do. So, you know, you don't gotta touch nothing you don't gotta touch no equipment if you know what's, you know what I mean? If you can tell somebody else what to do, you produce it. So I started doing that. And that's when I started producing. That's how I got into the producing. But just by watching him do it, I just learned how to do it myself. You know, when I got my own equipment, I just automatically zone it. doing my thing. Right. You know what I mean? So you know, that's what happened. You know, the first album was done by me and Chris together, and then when we got to the second album, it was mostly me. Okay. By then, I didn't need no more help. Right. I was on that shit.
Right.
You know what I mean? And Havoc still ain't on. He still have an issue.
Well, tell me this. How do you feel about people getting you confused with the other Havoc? Yes.
You know what? At this point, I really don't give a damn. Now, I don't. But you know, of course, through the years, yeah, it was a point in time when I wanted to beat the crap. I mean, I wanted to beat the shit out of them fools. Like, I didn't like them niggas. You know, it was because, you know, we had our one little encounter with them in Atlanta.
Yes, sir.
And nothing happened. You know what I mean? Nothing happened in Atlanta. It was a little confrontation. It wasn't really nothing, as far as I'm concerned. But then later down the line, Prode'je from Mobb Deep said that they confronted us in Atlanta and we were scared. So, you know, on some real type stuff, like, you don't say that some niggas were scared of you if that's not true. Like, you know what I mean? So, my problem with him is he lied. I got a problem with that one person now because of that. Now, as far as how I feel about people comparing us or confusing us with them, I mean, how can you not do that? Both, like, we Havoc and Prode'je. That's gonna confuse some motherfuckers.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? People are gonna be confused because we got the same damn name. It's just spelt different. How that happened? Have the fucking slightest.
Okay.
We was here first. That's all I got to say. We was here first. You know, and I was Prode'je a few years before the South Central Cartel even was formed. I put out a record as Prode'je first. Just me. So, you know, when these fools get to talking about, oh, y'all been our names, how the hell we write shit? Dude, I was Prodigy before I even started the South Central Cartel. You know, so, but I didn't like it. You know what I mean? But when we was in Atlanta, it was pretty much like, wasn't nothing finna happen. So, I was trying to, like, keep the stuff cool. You know what I mean? Like, Guru, rest in peace. Gangstar was there. He was like, man, y'all need to be tripping over that, blah, blah, blah. So, anyway, at the end of the day, it was a peace thing, y'all. Do what y'all doing over there. And we gonna do what we doing over here.
Right.
That's what it was. Y'all New York Havoc and Prode'je. We over here in LA, we was Havoc and Prode'je. Now, where the drama came in at was, when we were signed to Def Jam Records, the dude, one of the people that was high up in Def Jam at the time was Chris Lighty. Chris Lighty managed Mobb Deep. So, what ended up happening was South Central Cartel ended up being held down because this other person managed the other New York. First of all, Def Jam is a New York label, period. Yeah, they signed some West Coast artists or whatnot, but at that Def Jam, at that particular time, that was a New York record. That's where their allegiance was. We was over there. You know, SEC, we were selling a lot of records and stuff. It didn't have really a lot to do with Def Jam. You know, at the time, that's just what was cracking. The street rap was what was hot, and we was one of those groups that came out that caught a little buzz. You know, but I feel like we ended up getting caught up in some politics. Because it's hard for a person who managing this Havoc and Prode'je over here, but this Havoc and Prode'je is signed to the label that he has a lot of influence at because he worked there. I mean, he was like president or vice president over there. I feel like that definitely had a lot to do with why at a certain point we were stuck. Because, you know, we put out our album at Def Jam. We put out Gats We Trust. We didn't have another album come out on Def Jam until they put out Murder Squad Nationwide, which really wasn't a South Central Cartel album, but they put us on cover. So it's kind of like people might look at it almost in that way, but it really wasn't. We didn't put out another album, so our first Def Jam album came out in like 93, I think it was. We didn't put out another album until 97. So they basically sat on our stuff all the way up to like 1997. So we only put out two albums on Def Jam, but we were signed to the label for like 6-7 years. And you know, at the time when we was in the music, when we was cracking, like heavy cracking, people was putting out albums every year. We was doing an album every single year. We only got to do one record. We got one real record, which was the Gats We Trust. And then we had a Hard Day Every Day, which was probably our best record. They didn't do nothing with that record. At that time, we was like pissed off, tripping on the lane. Talking about letting us off. You know, we was on some, we had got fed up. We was like, y'all got to let us go. Ready to go. So, you know, of course they put the record out, but you know, now we tripping on them. You know, we ain't happy over there. So they kind of just sat on the record. And they like, I see some.
You see him?
I see darkness, but the screen changed from gray. I see something. I just see some light.
Hold on, I'm getting the producer over here.
Nick, I see somebody here.
That's me, Prode'je. I got it.
This is a good one.
Dude, why you talking like a baby, bro?
Hi, Havoc. I see your ear.
Nigga, your head so big, it's fit. Your head too big for the screen.
Turn some light on, Havoc.
All we see is your ear.
Turn some light on.
Oh, you don't want us to see your George Jefferson? Oh, that's why your ass in the dark. Put a hat on, nigga.
Okay, tell me about when Tupac came to West Coast. And you guys were out rocking. How did it change the West Coast?
The first time I heard about Tupac, he was already doing the thing with Digital Underground, right? So he was already on the West Coast. But when Tupac, like, really started, to me, Tupac, he definitely stepped that thug shit up a couple of notches. Like, you know, we already had the gangster rap over there, but Tupac, he kind of took it up some notches. Because you know how, this fool gone. You know how, I think some on the West Coast, not just the West Coast, just in the hip hop game, people have started talking a lot about studio gangsters and people that wasn't really with the business, but they were screaming all this gangster rap. Tupac came and just put the face to the shit. Tupac, even though he was real militant and, you know, he get political and into all of that type of thing, he still was like real gangster with it. In other words, to the point where if he didn't like you, he'd kick your ass. Like, he wasn't fake. You know, like, you know how some people are sitting next to you and they don't really like you, but they'll deal with you. Tupac had the energy of, if he didn't like you, he was just gonna let your ass know, I don't like you, bro. You know, so to me, he turned it up a couple of notches as far as just being a real person. You know what I mean? Now, all of a sudden, you had to be real, because if you came with some fakery, Pop probably was gonna call your ass out. You niggas ain't real. You know what I mean? So he, to me, it kind of brought a little bit of an era where it was some real, realness out there. You know what I mean? And you had to be, because he had the game on lock anyway. And I mean, Death Row in general had the game on lock. It's crazy because Death Row was already big when Pac got on the label, but when he got over there, he magnified that shit. Because the way he represented it was like, you know, he really talked about Death Row like, I don't know, man, he just made that shit just seem bigger than life in a way to me, the whole Death Row thing. But the energy Pac brought was definitely some hood shit, some thug shit, but intelligent. Intelligent too, you know what I mean? Because, you know, one minute Tupac loved the hell out of a woman and loved the homies. Next minute he beating the shit out of the homies, fuck the homies. Like, dude was, you know what I mean? He was like all over the place with it. But one thing about the boy, he was real. He was a real dude. If he liked you, he liked you. If he didn't fuck with you,
he knew about it.
He knew about it. He didn't fuck with you. He didn't bite his tongue. He didn't play. He was out with his shit. You know what I mean? That and you can actually see the old man.
Have a song here?
Yeah, I see him now.
Hey, have it.
Connect
the audio.
Now we can see him, but we can't hear the boy. This dude right here.
So, tell me about the industry, the music from then to now has changed. What do you think about that?
God. You know what? And it's probably going to sound like a broken record, because I'm sure you hear this all the time by everybody else. But basically, to me, like, all right, this is an example of the difference between the music business today and how it was when we was cracking. You could line up South Central Cartel, Compton's Most Wanted, MCA, Vice One, Above the Law, say Rapping Forte. Okay, all those group I just named don't sound nothing alike. We all had our own distinct sound about us. The cats that us out right now, you can't tell the fucking difference. You line up 5-6 different rappers and play their songs, to me all that shit sound the same. It all sound the same. It ain't about nothing. They don't stand for nothing. Now, you might say we was on some gangster rap, and a lot of people think we was on some negativity, but I guarantee you, you go buy all them gangster rap records, I guarantee you it's at least 2 or 3 songs on there where we talking some real shit. Like, I mean, like some uplifting type shit.
They have it.
Sound like you talking to somebody in the background.
I don't know. I can't get him.
I can hear his ass.
I can hear him too, a little bit.
There's no originality. Basically, that's what I'm trying to say. There's no originality. If one person make a hit, the next 10 records gonna sound just like that one hit record. And these niggas don't give a damn. They don't have no conscience about it. I mean, hey, you know, I'm not gonna even go into the mumble rap shit. I'm not gonna even get on that, you know, because at the end of the day, since I'm a OG, I've been around a long time, they gonna look at me and be like, nigga, you just too old to understand this shit. And I guess I am. Maybe that's what it is. I'm from the school where niggas said words.
So you still kick it with Spice One and those type of duck Rapping Forte and
CMA. I mean, I don't necessarily, per se, hang around with him. Abic is more of the hang around type guy, because he just was hanging out with Spice One and Bushwick Bill. But we all good. We all cool. You know what I mean? And I definitely when I can, I do business with them. Like if I produce somebody from wherever, they be like trying to get rappers on their record. They always want some of these OG cats. And I might holler at them like, man, I got a hookup for you, bro. You know what I mean? You can get this bread or something. So, you know, we all good like that. You know, but we all good. Ain't no issues amongst us. We all still got respect for each other. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. Can you tell me a little bit about some upcoming projects you got going on?
Yeah. Right now, I just put out a record. It's just the greatest hits of my stuff. But see, like when I do I put out a record called Gangster Eternal, Big Prode'je Gangster Eternal. And it's just records that I done through the years. It's old stuff to me, but ain't nobody heard it. So technically it's new shit. Right. To the world, ain't nobody never heard it. So, you know, I did that. And right now I'm working on a project with my bro, Cali Pitts. I'm working on his album. Then I got another young artist, his name's Heir to Prophecy. I'm working on that project. Okay. And I'm doing all my stuff now through my own label, Hood Good.
Okay.
You know, Havoc got Game Changer. He's doing everything over there with Game Changer. But I got my own thing over here, which is good. But we also have a new, I got a new South Central Cartel project called Cartelifornia. And we working on that too. Okay. And you know, next year, SCC gonna be doing, we gonna be doing a lot of shows, like car shows, try to get on a lot of these, like, you know, them OG gangster rap tours and stuff like that.
Okay.
Trying to get back out here and start pushing that again.
Absolutely. Is there any advice you can give any upcoming artists that is?
I can give them some advice. You know, the best advice I can give these cats is be yourself, man. Be original. You know, step out there. You know what I mean? Chance the Rapper to me is a cat that step out there. You know, Kendrick Lamar is a cat to me that step out there. Matter of fact, I think the TDE record label, all the people that signed to them basically step out there. They not trying to sound like everybody else on the radio.
Right.
They trying to do something creative, something, you know, some game changing type shit. Like, man, be the best you that you can be. Don't be the best somebody else, you know what I mean? Just to get the little quick bread, you don't gotta sound like, sometimes when you create your own land, you make more money because you created that. You know, you created that. You're not just like a fly-by-night artist. Because when you come out, you do a record that sound like whatever's on the radio, then you might come in and pop for a minute. Like, a lot of the time, you're going to be a one-hit wonder or something because you don't have your own lane. You're borrowing a little bit of this cat's lane. You know what I mean? So, to these young cats coming up, man, be original. And give a damn. You know, give a damn about what you're doing. Give a damn about your art. Don't be satisfied with the fact that you can get on a record and say, hey, all the way through it. And that's it. And because the big bang. You just say, hey, all the way through the whole fucking song. I ain't trying to diss what's his face. What's that full name? Yachty? Lil Yachty? I'm not dissing Lil Yachty. I mean, you know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, I respect any black man getting money. Anyway, so you know what I mean, and Lil Yachty, since I seen the recent interview with him, and he seemed like he's getting better as far as, you know, having a little bit more respect for the OGs and the people that came before him. You gotta give a damn, you know what I mean, because to me, when you get in this music business and you become successful, that's a blessing. That's a blessing. You ain't supposed to get in this music game and start acting like, well, I didn't do both of it, but I just happened to get in it. Now I'm spending all this money. You know, it ain't that serious to me. I ain't gonna talk about what's going on in the world because it don't affect me because I'm rich. Get the out of here. Get the fuck out of here. If you in this music business and you making money, then somebody looking up to you, homie. Somebody looking up to you. Even if you don't want to give a damn, you should give a damn. You know what I mean? It ain't about just getting your little money and going home and worrying about your immediate family, bro. Because if you in a position where you can say something, I ain't talking about give nobody no bread, but just open your mouth and say something and the kids might just listen to you, then that's important. So, you know, these fools need to really give a damn. Not just about the money, but about the culture. The culture of rap, because it's changing like a motherfucker. So when you start not giving a damn, but you are the ones that's carrying on the tradition, that's not a good look. Because now y'all carrying on the tradition, but y'all got the OGs looking at y'all like, damn, we built all this just to hand it to you niggas? And you niggas don't have no respect for not only for what came before you, but for what you do. Just because you can get on the record and turn up on the whole record without saying two sentences don't mean you should do that. Maybe two or three niggas should do that, but not the whole damn gang. So, original. Be original. Try to. You know what I mean? Dig in a little bit. Don't be scared to try some new shit.
Gotcha.
That's my advice to the youngsters.
So, how do you feel that Trump's in the office?
Oh my God. I mean, you know what? How do you feel? That's how I feel. I don't like that shit. Like, but what, you know, my thing is, he's in office. He's in office.
So, you think they should do a recount?
Huh?
You think they should do this recount?
I don't give a fuck what they recount. He's the president. He's the president. Nothing's gonna change. Dude won. I don't know if he won it fair and square. I don't know if he cheated. I don't know what he did. But what I do know is, he won. Do I like it? Hell no. What? Gotta live with it.
Tell me what artists that out of everybody that's rocking right now that you will go out and buy their album. One artist.
Right now?
Yeah.
That's hard. I just named Chance the Rapper.
Chance the Rapper.
I like Chance the Rapper because he's a real artist to me. Of course, I like Kendrick Lamar. I got Kendrick's record. It's a lot of them, honestly. There's a lot of them under the radar that's not really getting. And I don't even know all the names because my son be playing this stuff. And I be like, man, who is that?
Right.
Cause I'll be liking that shit.
Right.
You know what I mean? There's a lot of them out there that's good. My son listen to the, he don't listen to the mainstream stuff. He right. listen to the stuff that, you know, that a lot of people probably don't they don't play it on the radio.
Right.
They don't play it on the radio. Not on regular radio, at least. They don't play it. But, I mean, right off the top of my head, I got a name. I can say Kendrick, and I can say I like Schoolboy Q. I like Ab Soul. You know, these are all people that don't stick to the status quo.
Okay.
They doing their own thing. I like rappers that's doing their own thing. I don't like rap. I like J. Cole. I like J. Cole new shit. I love that new shit he putting out right now. I gotta give it to him. I like the shit he's saying.
Yeah,
he talking shit, and I like it.
Yeah.
No, it ain't nothing wrong with being creative, bruh. You could be a real hip-hop artist, real motherfucker, and still do your thing. That dude still making crazy bread.
Right, you're right.
Mumbling on the fucking records.
Yeah, he's making sense. He has something to relate to. I have to agree. He's one of my favorites right now.
No doubt about it.
So we couldn't get Havoc on this interview.
Havoc did was interrupt my flow. That's it. Came in, background noise and shit.
Can you tell the viewers your social media information?
Yeah. Big Prode'je. Prode'je Hood. Facebook is Prode'je Hood. Twitter is Mr. Hood Good. And I don't know why I don't have the same name on everything, but basically you can just pretty much put Prode'je in your browser and my shit just shows up, all of it. But it's Big Prode'je on Mr. Hood Good on Twitter. It's Big Prode'je on Instagram, and it's Prode'je Hood on Facebook.
Okay. Do you want to give any shout outs?
Not really.
No shout outs to nobody.
I ain't got nobody to shout out. You know, I just wanna say, you know, to all you cats out there that give a damn about hip hop and you got the balls to go in the studio and create something fresh or something that's you, man, I wanna give y'all a shout out. All you fools out there mumbling and shit, figure it out. That's it.
Thank you, Prode'je, for taking the time out for me. You have been so awesome, so patient with us. Please tune in to GettyDownRadio.com on our YouTube channel, Getty Down Radio. Please keep in touch. And
get you on with Cali Picks. That's who I'm going to get you on with, my brother, Cali Picks.
Soon as possible. I'm ready for him, okay? Bring them. Bring everybody.
I got your number now.
Tell Havoc, send Bushwick Bill to me. Send me Spice One. I want all of them. Tell them to come on.
Oh, Havoc. You want some people? Havoc is the social butterfly.
Okay. Tell them to come on. That's all I need. Okay? And don't forget, like I said, you got my link. I don't sleep, so let me know whenever. Okay?
I'll be at you. Sure, I'm gonna get at you.
I really do appreciate you, okay?
And I appreciate you.
Hey, don't forget to email me some drops.
Got you.
Okay?
I got you. All right.
Have a good one.
So just send it back to the email that's it that y'all send me.
Yep, GettyDownRadio@gmail.com. Send the drops to that. Thank you.
All right. Y'all have a good night.
You too.
Cartels coming real. Who banging like a G, ready to ride and regulate it all. Been is essential in the sea when I'm mad dog. The khaki stay creased and we mob like the Nazis. Two G's are putting it down, call us the twin John Gotti. See eyes on the tip and the eyes are ready to ride. But I don't see Nathan wrong, so I hit and shake the spot. G from my campus, leaving a snap of pure funk. From the trunk to the ear as the 12 Vegas bump. I make your head bob as we slide block to block. Low grind and got me gone. Crack the window to release the smoke. Yeah, Rhyme Sun is seeing demons. Cut the braids, yo, the fiend and fold the semen. And I'm skiing. It's acting and back hits when we ride on your click. Full clip, G's ain't the G's to be messing with. SC Cartel dwells in the slum, slanging crumbs. That's your best if you eat. I let this line steal, hum. Yeah, all day, every day, I don't give up. Right. Long as I got on my khakis, t-shirt, and chucks. When I'm rolling through LA, what do I see? A gang of mo is dressed just like me. All day, every day, I don't give up. Right. Long as I got on my khakis, t-shirt, and chucks. When I'm rolling through Chicago, what do I see? A gang of mo dressed just like me. Rolling in my low, but I'm not solo. My heat is an AK, underlay to bust 8. Capping a fool, quicker than a G. So that's who I rolls with when I'm twisted D's. My dress code's casual, you know the routine. Khaki t-shirts and chucks looking hella clean. My low sweat, so what's next? I can hit a switch and make you fresh. Trying to sweat a young vet, cool. Ain't nothing going on but the gangster. South Central's finest, murder squad's finest. Trying to take my low
solo. I'll be doing 24 low low with an L. That's on my baby girl. You see these bullets coming at ya. They'll snatch ya. Caught up in the rapture. You wanna see me, the OG from the SC swap meet dweller. Quick to put a cap in your cellar.
All day, every day, I don't give up. Yeah, long as I got on my khakis, t-shirt, and chucks. Rolling through Atlanta, what do I see? A gang of mope is dressed just like me. All day, every day, I don't give up. Yeah, long as I got on my khakis, t-shirt, and chucks. Rolling through St. Louis, what do I see? A gang of mope is dressed just like me. Ta-da-ow. How you like me now as I skate in the rag gate with MCA? Collect the stripes, jumping all night. We too tired as we ride. Slide with the heat on my side. My 45 and knock your chest closer to the sky. Partner, you best to break fast like juice. Betting 32 loose from the carbine dude. We broke the truce, so when I go, y'all got to bury me. In my Chuck D's, khakis, and BPT, y'all feeling me? Still a G. Cold, drop the bow and roll to the stove for yak. I get spent like that. Rat that tat like Mac 10. Hit the corner and spin on them. DJ, we serve your G. Partner, this SEC. We regulate the SE. We put it down for CC. We baby night next to me. And when we done, we head hunting for punks. So your best to try. Play rug and lie. All day, every day, I don't give up. Right. Long as I got on my khakis, t-shirt, and chucks. Rolling through Texas, what do I see? A gang of mo dressed just like me. All day, every day, I don't give up. Right. Long as I got on my khakis, t-shirt, and chucks. Rolling through Oakland, what do I see? A gang of mo dressed just like me. All day, every day, I don't give up. Yeah. Long as I got on my khakis, t-shirt, and chucks. Rolling through Hilltown, what do I see? A gang of mo is dressed just like me. All day, every day, I don't give up. Yeah. Long as I got on my khakis, t-shirt, and chucks. Rolling through Naptown, what do I see? A gang of mo dressed just like me. All day, every day, I don't give up. Long as I got on my khakis, t-shirt, and chucks. When I'm all over the West Coast, what do I see? A gang of G dressed just like me. Yeah.